But you're not obvious.
What up? Hey guys, I'm gonna give you a few minutes to get in. I'm gonna finish up this song. I'm gonna crack back on this excess energy. Tonight's gonna be a super fun night. So, what's up, Calvin Burkhart? What's up, brother? What up, Benjamin? What's up, Nathan? One base hit at a time, that's right. I gotta watch that up there, I think. So I kind of got to have a couple of screens here. If you guys see me looking all over the fucking place, it's because I'm running a Zoom tonight, guys, so that I can invite one of our members in here. But let me get a few more people in here, and we'll just keep on rocking. If you have questions, post away. What happening? What up, Kyle? I jumped in a few minutes early, as you guys can tell. I normally jump in at 6:30 Mountain Standard Time, but I wanted to get in so people can get on here. Then I'll start talking about 6:30, and I'll talk to you guys for a few minutes, and then I'm going to be inviting an OG, one of the prior members in here. His name is Ben Batosh. I'm sure some of you guys have heard of him, but I'm going to be inviting him on here so that he can talk to you guys about the journey, what he's went through, some of the cool stuff that he can give you guys knowledge on. I think that's really important. So that's what I'm going to be doing here in a minute. But first and foremost, I seen some of you guys out there, right? Some of you guys out there are hitting those singles and doubles, which I fucking love. So congratulations on hitting those singles and doubles. Let me bring this screen down. So I feel like I'm looking up at you the whole time. So I got to have, just so you guys know, I got to have one screen down here where I can see your comments, answer your questions. And then I had another screen up top so that I can, it's actually a Zoom screen. It allows me to Zoom at the same time that we do live so I can invite people on here with me. So what I was saying is I see some of you guys out there like hitting doubles, hitting singles, and that's what it takes, right? Day in and day out. We got to train our mind to never quit, right? I know with me, like, I'll hit a single, hit a double. I'll feel really good about it. My whole week starts going good. That momentum starts building, but sometimes it kind of dips back down, and we got to train our mind to not let that affect us. Right. So understand, Nathan, I love the fact you're out there hitting singles, freaking Ben's hitting freaking home runs. By hitting singles, he hit a few home runs, and you'll hear about those here in a little bit. But you got to train your mind, because you're going to have ups and downs in this business, just like any other fucking business out there. Right. No matter what business you get into, the only difference with this one, it doesn't cost as much to get started. You can freaking get in here and put as much time as you want into it, right? It's not something that, like, you'll die tomorrow if you all of a sudden go to the lake tomorrow. You're not gonna kill your business with it, right? And some of these brick and mortars are like that, right? So at least you get a little bit more free time with this. It doesn't cost a fucking $1 million to get started. You don't have overhead of a fucking building to keep running, right? So it's a beautiful business. It's beautiful to be in this space right now. Really think of how many businesses out there that are dying. How many businesses are dying from COVID? How many brick and mortars are dying because they have overhead of a building, utilities, insurance, a bunch of shit that just stacked on top of them, when you guys are sitting here with tools in your tool belt where you can go out or you can work from home or from your couch. Shit, some of you are working from Starbucks, right? And you're able to do that day in and day out and make a healthy fucking living, like super, super cool that you guys chose this tool for your tool belt. But I will be, let me see what's, hey man, you can't be, let me read some of your comments real quick. If you guys have comments for me, I want you guys to kind of ask them right now. I know some of you guys have questions for me. I want to be able to get those out of the way. But here in a little bit, you're going to be able to ask Ben some questions as well. What's up, Don Green? Bam, bam, bam. Hey man, can't be hiding the hair from us. I know. Check it out. So my wife says I need a touch up because obviously you can see the dark through it or whatever. My real hair color is coming back. We even talked about going pink with it a little bit. I think I'm going through a little bit of a midlife crisis, right? Like I'm traveling a lot. I'm always wanting to be on vacation. We've only been, hell, you guys don't know, is I went out to Phoenix for a month. We came back here. I was here for 2 days and then I was like, peace. Went out to Tijuana. And we were there for like a week and then I just got back. I've been home for like 2 days and we're just like, I've been like working my ass off the last 2 days, but every part of my being just wants to go on vacation again. Right. So it's kind of nice once you guys start building this up. And I want you to hear from real students that went through the same thing that you went through. He actually is 11 months. I think he's been in 11 months, 12 months, 11 months, I think is really it. Cause you guys, what you guys need to realize too, and another thing I want to touch base on, is just because you get started in this course last month or whatever, the time doesn't start ticking, guys, until you have a fucking website live, until you have a lead gen up, until you started prospecting, until you started putting lines in the water. You can't start counting your time, right? Like you're learning this skill set. You're learning this every day in and day out. You're in there learning. So understand, if you've been in here for a little while, maybe you're not prospecting, you kind of let it sit. If you haven't started putting up lead gens, get your ass in there and start putting up lead gens right now. Like for me, the way that I got super successful with this is I put up so many fucking lead gens, there was no way I could fail, right? Lead gens are also a part of your foundation. So the very first site you guys go in and you set up is your agency site, right? Builds your foundation. But it doesn't mean that you shouldn't circle back around. Even if you're landing SEO deals and all that stuff, it doesn't mean you shouldn't circle back around and build yourself a lead gen, right? At the end of the day, that lead gen is going to produce you money day in and day out. My wife was just talking to me about this, but we bring in right around $56,000 a month just in lead gens alone. Not SEO clients, not fucking Google ads, not Facebook ads, not all the other shit that I have going on with my tools that I learned, right? And the same tools that you guys are learning, but just lead gens alone. So if you don't have a lead gen yet, if you've been here a while, you already have your agency side up, all that, and you don't have your own lead gen, I really implore you to get out there right now and start building out those lead gens. Build out 5 to 10 lead gens, build out 3 lead gens, whatever you can handle. Let's get out there and get it done. That's a foundation builder. That shit, like you guys just seen Seth post today, right? Seth is super busy. He's making money doing a bunch of other shit with the tools that he has as well, SEO and this and that. And he built out lead gens. And he's got guys in this course, I think Grant, Demetrius, he's got different guys in here that are super good at selling these things. And Seth doesn't have the time. So he sent these lead gens over to them. Now all of a sudden they're making $1,000 a month. And I think he's paying Grant, you know, 20 or 30% of it just to make that quick sale. So, you know, just get out there and build these lead gens up, build these properties up, build up your foundations, build up your life, build up your empire. Don't just sit on your tools. Okay. It's like having a tool belt and instead of putting it on your waist, you're putting it on the seat and you're sitting down on it. You're covering up your tools. You need to be out there every single day, prospecting, building your own lead gens, building your empire, and making shit happen. And if you guys need help, if it's your first lead gen, whatever, I'm down to jump on a Zoom with you. I'm down to do, you know, a group call this week that we can all jump on a Zoom, go through and we'll create, you know, we'll start looking for niches for you, tell you what to build, help you with keyword research. But let's start doing that. Let's start getting out there and making this shit happen. My agency will have links to its portfolio, my LGs. Agency will have links to its portfolio, my LGs. Good. Yeah, you can definitely do that. So you can take your lead gens. Nick has some lead gens. He's got his agency site here. He's taking his LGs and he's linking back to his agency site to help push that up. You can absolutely do that. Is there a way to speed results up for SEO? It takes forever to start to see the results. Grr. No, actually it doesn't. So what you're seeing is you're thinking it's taking a long time to see the results. But webmaster tools will show them to you right away. So make sure that you have your, and it's in the training, make sure that you have the actual site in webmaster tools. And if you do, then Google will show you the links when they find them, and they'll show you the keywords when they find them and what you're being found for. What I found is that AREFs takes like 45 days sometimes to start finding this stuff for you. So if you're an AREFs trying to see, hey, did they find that link for me, et cetera, really, it's going to take 45 days for them to find it. Okay. So don't depend solely on that. That's why inside the training, if you guys go to client retention and then you go down, you're going to see webmaster tools, how to set that up. And then you're going to be able to actively see when Google finds a link for your site, you'll be able to see it right away. And when Google finds a new keyword for you or pushes you up in search rankings, you can see all that on webmaster tools. It's in the training. It shows you how to use it too. Okay. That and analytics are going to be your best friend when it comes to that, because otherwise we're looking at it. That's kind of what I was telling you about training our brain to never quit. Because if we throw up a lead gen and we think it's not going anywhere and no links are being found and no keywords are being found, we almost give up after a little while, right? 45 days can seem like a lifetime. But if you have it set up correctly and you're looking in webmaster tools, you're going to see changes every single day. Okay. And same thing with analytics. Analytics, actually, if you set up your analytics, which is in there as well, it'll show you when somebody's actively on your site as well. Okay. So if you got a lead gen, you can actively see somebody come to your site. We do this with Mr. and Mrs. Leeds all day. We sit there and watch 3, 4, 5 people on our site at a time. And you can watch it in live time on analytics. Okay. So don't get disappointed there, right? Stay hungry and just keep learning. Let's get it set up correctly so you can actually see what's happening. I hope that helped you a little bit. Elia, do it. Boom, boom, boom. Let me see if we got good. A lot of comments. Bop, bop, bop. Elia, bop, bop, bop. I can't see all of them for some reason. It's not loading. Cool. I hope that did it for you there. Let me pull this back up real quick. All right. All right, so if you guys have any other questions, I guess just hit me up on there. For right now, what I'm going to do, guys, is I'm going to bring on a guy for you. This guy, he's been in the group for about 12 months now, probably about 2 months, I think. He played around for about 2 months of really learning the skill set, you know, putting the tools in his tool belt, building out his first lead gen. He didn't want to get into SEO, and that's fine. Guys, understand that if you don't want to go the SEO route, the Facebook ads, SEO, blah, 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 and you don't need money right now, but you still want to build yourself an empire, you still want to make a bunch of money online, then definitely start putting up lead gens. And that's the direction that this guy went. He actually started putting up lead gens a couple months after he was in the course. But listen, I don't want to blow his story, so let me get him on here, and he can kind of break it down for you. Ben, go ahead. If you're on here, I'm going to be shooting you a link. Let me see real quick. And it looks like he just asked me something on here too. All right, Ben, jump on that link when you get a second here and I'll get you in here. You can introduce yourself. We'll get you going. Give me a second. And guys, if you have questions for Ben as well, I want to make sure that you guys are asking away. I think it's really like cool when you can bring in like a guy like me that's been at it, you know, six plus years here, you know, I'm kind of like at this different level where I have a different understanding than a guy like Ben that's just like you guys, right? That comes in and is able to do what he's done, and you guys can hear a story from him. But you guys sat in the same shoes, right? Some of you are actually in worse, or he was in worse shoes than where you're currently at, and he's been able to come in and really change his life, change his lifestyle, change everything that he has going on for himself. So let me see real quick. Ben, I hope that you've seen that. See if he's jumping in here. Oh, yep. Hold on. I can get him in right here. Ben, more promote. I got to promote you real quick, bro. I'll get you in here. Let's see. There we go. Unmute. All right. Are you there? Does everybody see any of you? Go ahead and talk.
Can you hear me?
Let's test. I think they can see you. Let's find out. Boom, 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 boom. Let me know if you guys can see Ben. Yep, they can see you. So I think we're good there. All right. So for you guys that don't know Ben, like I said, he's been in, I think, right at a year. And Ben, go ahead and tell your story. When you jumped in, obviously tell me some of the fears that you were feeling, kind of what you went through, the process, all that good stuff.
Dude, where can I start? I mean, starting with a cold call. I never did a cold call before. Like, just something as simple as that. You know, but whatever fears I had, obviously I didn't die from them, you know, so I just kept going. Like, cold call, you know, I was stuttering in the beginning. I didn't really know what I was saying. I didn't really know what I was doing. But over time, you know, you just get the hang of it. The more experiences you have, the more reps you get under your belt, you know, the more unconscious it becomes. And it becomes, you know, I can talk about this stuff in my sleep now. So, yeah.
So let's go back to you first getting in the course. So tell me a little bit about your background before you jumped in, before you got started. What were you doing? What did you do for a living and everything?
Yes. Yeah, so I was playing college basketball. Basketball was my entire life. It was everything that I wanted to do. I had an injury that set me back, and, you know, slowly I just started thinking, you know, what can I do? What can I really do? I want to do my own thing. And, you know, slowly just started with innocently searching online. How do I make money online? Then came across the BAM course, spoke to Josh over the phone. I felt the sincerity, Josh is a very genuine guy. And I got that from him over the phone and decided to pull the trigger. Took me about a few months to really get loose, this is one of the drawbacks I had, was that I'm a super perfectionist. So if I can give the newbie advice, mess up, do it, mess up, and then fix it later, because it will never be a perfect time. You're not going to know until you do it. So to that newbie out there, I would definitely say just pull the trigger and just do it. I got started in a very tough niche. I'm from New York City. And if you guys don't know, there's a lot of hard asses and a lot of people that are tough out here, and they just have, you know, their defense, like they're very defensive to everything. So cold calling them, it took me a while to get the hang of it. I was in a niche that was very tough in towing.
Well, hold on. So hold on, go back for a second. So one thing, so you were in college, right? Okay, so you're in college. How long did you go to college?
Yeah, I was in school for 5 years.
All right, so basketball. Five years, what did you go to school for?
Business. I didn't learn shit about business.
Okay, so really you went to school for basketball.
I went to school to play basketball.
That's it. So, boom, did 5 years in college. Did you have to pay for any of that shit, or was that like student loans? Like, do you still owe money?
A little bit. I have a little bit of student loans. Yeah. Yeah, a little bit.
Okay. So, you got a little bit of that to pay off. And then the only reason I'm bringing that up, because I just looked at comments and Calvin just said, "Hey, Ben, your pad looks upgraded, bro."
Oh, so, yeah. That's another thing. I was going to get into that slowly. So to resume back to the story, I mean, I got started in the towing niche. One thing that I want you guys to know, I know Josh was talking about lead gens. When deciding to build a lead gen, it's important to know some niches are very GMB dominant, some are very organic dominant, some work better in ads. You won't know until you do it though. So moral of the story, I got my first lead, got very excited, right? I was like, wow. And I remember hitting up Josh, what do I do? He was like, start calling people, you know? Like, so I started calling people and then ended up getting to one guy who ended up taking the leads, turned out well, turned into a monthly deal. Fast forward, I ended up flipping that lead gen site. So that's another positive to building a lead gen, is you really have full ownership. You could do whatever you desire with it. I decided to really focus on certain niches, and I wanted to get rid of, the pain in the ass clients that I had. Because in some niches, you'll learn that. Some niches, you're going to get tougher people to deal with. So I ended up flipping that lead gen, ended up flipping another one for a really high amount. If you guys really want to know, you can ask me.
Hold on, let's go back a second. I think Ben made a good point here. Is like, not all fucking niches are created equal, okay? And some of you out there are going to really get along with certain individuals. Like, I told Ben before he even did it. When he came out and he was like, I'm going to go into towing, I was like, bro, don't do it. I hate towing companies. Don't do it. Don't do it. And fucking he went for it anyway, right? And so that's just me. Maybe I put too much pressure on him there. But either way, you still turn, you know, a negative situation because you didn't like working with towers either, right? Like, you were making money off of it, but it was kind of a pain in the ass, right? Like, you were always pulling your hair out to get paid by this guy, right?
So yeah, and this is the thing. Go ahead. Go ahead, go ahead.
No, you're good.
So in towing, I learned quickly the people are not the type of people I want to deal with. And you'll learn that as you go. But I don't regret it because it taught me very valuable business knowledge that I needed to understand. I needed to know that you can't getting a business degree and going to school. So you just learn in the field. And that's really the biggest thing. If I could give you guys one piece of advice, just fucking do it and then you'll fix it later. Seriously. And then you'll figure out what's best for you. I'm still figuring it out as I go. I mean, I'm about a year in now and it's really starting to pick up. Like Josh was saying, the pad got upgraded. I ended up getting my own place. I was living at home. Fresh out of college, I was still living, you know, with my family. And, you know, now I've been very fortunate enough, you know, to have the capital to, you know, and all this is all from this business, you know, which is a beautiful thing. And I built lead gens and they're still paying me now. And I haven't done any type of work to them. And that's the leverage you get from being in this business. And, you know, if you really lock in and go hard, you know, there were days, man, I didn't sleep, pulled all nighters. You're going to go through that. If you really want this shit, that's what you really got to do. And, you know,
let's go back when you first started, because I remember this pretty clear. There was ups and downs with you too, right? Like I said, you got to train your brain to never quit. But there was times that you had ups. There was times you had downs. There was times that you know what I mean? Do you remember those times a little bit? Because I remember them. I'm your coach. Every time you came, I was like, oh, Ben, don't worry about it. Like, it's going to happen, right? So talk a little bit about that up and down and how you kept pressing forward. Because I know there was times that you would spend hours and hours on. There was times that I was pretty sure Ben fucking took a hiatus for 7 days, right? Like, so, tell us a little bit about that process and what goes through your mind. And, like, you know, you just kept coming back to the board, bro. You just kept coming back to the board. You kept trying to score those singles and doubles and look where you're at now, right? And so talk a little bit about the process of your mind. Like what did you go through there?
So the process, I was super sold on what we do and the results that we bring. The problem that I was running into was the people that I decided to work with. So I took the path of least resistance in doing commission deals with a lot of the contractors, which ended up biting me in the ass looking back. But I did learn very valuable stuff within that and knowing, like, okay, this is what I do. This is non-negotiable. I do not do commission. I do either per lead or monthly. And as you gain experience, you'll start to lay down the law. That's definitely something that's very important. You'll learn. Another very valuable thing that I learned through my downs was, man, I bet literally everything that I had, all my capital, all my resources down on this business. I went into debt for this business to really make it work. And looking back now, if you're not willing to risk it all, you're not going to be successful. So you're either going to play to win or you're going to play to not lose. I'm going to play to win. So
what Ben's saying here is that if you're playing this like a fucking hobby, get out. You're wasting your fucking time. This is not a hobby. This is a business.
Get a job.
This is a day in and day out business for you to run. Yeah. And yeah, you can get started at 2 hours a day, you know, 2-3 hours a day, start building up your income, just like Ben did, just like I did, just like Calvin did, just like all these other guys did, right? And you can start building it up. But at some point, you have to realize that this is a business. This is not a hobby, and you must sink more and more time into it to make it happen. But once you do, obviously get where Ben is now. And just to give you guys an idea of what Ben was talking about on commission deals, was Ben was taking a percentage. So he would send a lead to a business and he would take a percentage from that lead. So let's say they sell a $1,000 job. Ben was taking, you know, $150 for that lead, right? Is that correct?
Yeah. So what I learned was you're not using your time to the best of your abilities, meaning you constantly have to follow up with these people, especially if you haven't built a certain level of trust. You know, a lot of these guys, I got screwed over a lot of money, very transparent. I'll be very transparent. I ended up catching some guys, you know, lying on some deals that they did. From my experience though, what I've learned is the best way to get started as far as if you want to do lead gen, offer that value for free and don't ask for anything in return. And then what you'll find is you'll really learn a lot about the person that you've given the lead to by giving him free stuff. And then once you gain some intel on who that person is, how they do business, you can really make that decision like, okay, do I really want to pursue or do I want to go in another direction? And it comes back to having abundance. So when you're making cold calls, really have five, six, seven, even eight people, get them interested. Spend a whole day cold calling. You know, I fucking hated cold calling, but looking back, every time I spent the whole day doing cold calling, it always turned into fucking money. Always.
Oh, every day. Always. Bro, if I get on the phone for 8 hours, we're so fucking slammed, we can't take on work for another month. You know what I mean? So it's there, especially with the tools and knowledge that you have. And when you compare yourself to other marketers out there with these tools, you just blow them away, right? And you blow business owners
away. Blow them away.
Yeah.
Blow them away. And when you have value to give them, it'll really tell you a lot about them. And then if one guy is a little hesitant, definitely one thing you guys to keep in mind, if you get a little bit of hesitance from someone and your instincts aren't aligned with where you want to go, like from what they're giving you, move on. Go move on right away. If you get a weird feeling, just fucking move on. Have some people lined up. Think about it. You have money for these people. So you don't think you could get 5 to 10 people interested from spending maybe 3 to 4 hours cold calling. It's pretty simple. It's simple, but it's not easy. Okay. As much as you guys want to hear, it's fucking easy. It's simple in theory, but doing the work is another fucking story. So if you really want to do the work, if you really want to make this shit work, you gotta sacrifice. You know, what are you willing to sacrifice? I was willing to sacrifice sleep. I was willing to sacrifice my social life. I was willing to sacrifice. I even made a post about this with Josh, to Josh, when I got a really big SEO deal. A lot of people were making fun of me when they were like, what are you doing now? Cause I've been associated my whole life as a basketball player. So then they're like, oh, what are you doing now? And it's like, oh, I'm actually doing marketing, you know, for construction and medical companies. And then they're like, what? Like, you work from home? Like, what do you do? Are you like, what are you doing? And it's kind of like, you know, I was being made fun of, and all those that it really tests you. It tests your character. It tests your self-esteem. And it's really a beautiful thing when you can look back and be like, yeah, I overcame this. You know, for me, it took me a little bit longer than I had hoped. But, you know, we're still chipping away every day. You know, I'm definitely not where I want to be. But looking back, you know, one of my goals was I live in my own apartment. I live in my own fucking apartment now. You know, it's the truth. And, you know, that was one of the goals I set. I obviously have other goals, but definitely whoever really wants it, they're going to go get it. And it's, man, I could talk about this all day.
Is it beautiful or what? So what I'm hearing you saying is like progress equals happiness, right? Like at the end of the day, not only are you happy about where you've been able to reach, but along the way, you've learned so much, right? I see, like, I remember the first time I met you, Ben, I was like, man, this kid's going to have to overcome himself a lot to make this shit happen. I remember that. I remember going, first time I met you, I'm like, he's a go-getter, but there's going to be times that he's really going to have to put it in to make this happen and overcome some of that shit you had going on, whether like self-doubt or whatever it may be. Or like, I remember there was a time even when I thought, what the fuck is Ben doing? I think you were when you first got in, you were clubbing and shit, right? And then you had to go because you were doing a towing company. He had to stop clubbing and he had to start picking up the phones at 3 o'clock in the morning, right? Is that true?
And I did.
And you did, yeah. And so there was shit that you had to sacrifice to make it happen, to really get that progress to get to where you are today. And just so you guys know, I know he talked a little bit about getting the wrong type of client in, a towing company. Tell us a little bit about what you did with that site, what you did with that company, because you didn't like working with them.
Man, okay. So as we were doing those month-to-month deals, you know, a lot of these people, they really test you and they'll pay you late, you know, and these are the type of people, it's very important to lay down the law. And that's something that I didn't do initially. It was a very, very valuable learning lesson. So, I mean, listen, we have the power in Legion. We really have the power. So I turned off his leads. And then what happened about 5 minutes later, he gave me my monthly, what we agreed on. So what I learned was, like I just said, lay down the law. But at the end of the day, we have the power. And then what I did was I ended up flipping that lead gen to him because I didn't really want to deal with him. I flipped it for $6,500. So
you sold it to him for $6,500?
I flipped it, you know, and I also have
a
ton
of... How much money do you think... how long did you rent it to him before you sold it?
9 months.
9 months. How much per month do you think you were pulling off of it?
$350 when I could have very easily been doing $500 and above.
You got about $3,000 out of it and then finally flipped it to him for $6,500. So you made about $9,500 on that deal, right?
Yep. And I barely put in.
How much did you put into it?
Man, it was literally getting GMB and doing very, very, it's very minimal work for towing because it's a very GMB dominant niche. That's what I learned. So first lead came in 5 days and then it was, okay, we got to find someone. So that's what you'll learn. You'll learn as you experiment with different niches. And then over time, you'll really figure out what you want to do and what you want to scale with. Over the past few months, I've determined that I really want to go into the medical niches. And, you know, I got a huge SEO deal in a big, big medical niche. And
talk to us a little bit about that. So you got... And that was your first SEO deal, correct?
Yeah. So I really wanted to just focus on lead gen. And I learned, like, why not take the SEO? I mean, it's there. So I took it and now delivering a ton of value. They're very happy and it's going to lead to so much more.
And what do they pay you per month right now?
This one client pays me $4,100 a month.
$4,100.
So that's a full-time, well, to some people, that's a full-time salary. So, right. And that's something that ultimately outsourced to, you know, the people who can handle some of the tedious tasks. That's the beauty about our business. I know Josh was talking about profit margins and, you know, not much, you don't really need much to get started. You just need a vision, you need a drive, and you need a plan. And, you know, I mean, it doesn't even need to be that organized. Just fucking do it. And then you can always recalibrate. Seriously, it's the truth.
No, that's so true. I got students jumping in right now, bro. And like, seriously, they're like 2-3 weeks in. And I'm like, how the fuck are you landing these deals? And you haven't even built your agency site yet, but they're in there and they just went straight to selling. They're like, they're just using their networks. They're just cold calling. They're just hitting it. And they just wanted to make that money. And the truth is that, yeah, you don't have to be that organized, right? You can go through the videos real quick. You can understand the concepts. And if you're decent at sales, if you're even just a little bit decent at sales and you follow my processes, you can fucking make money, right? And so that's a beautiful thing. So realistically, when I'm listening to your story, you really hit like that 9 month mark, right? You're like 9 months in and you're like, okay, I'm going to hyper focus in this area, right?
Right.
And so some of your lead gens didn't live up to that area. So instead of keeping your focus or even messing with them, I know some of them made money for you, but you were like, okay, I'm done messing with these ones or taking up more of my time. I want to focus over here and I want to go land, you know, 5 more clients at $4,100, right? And so you're moving your time in a little bit. I know you still have lead gens, so you still make money on lead gens and you make money on SEO. But talk to me a little bit about, I know there was another one in there that you built out, you charged them monthly, probably for 9 months as well, right?
Yeah, so this is funny. So you guys could actually go back to the video and bam, if you guys scroll. So I was having trouble finding a construction client for one of my lead gens. Josh was like, man, and this is what I love about Josh. He really walks the walk. So when I first got on the phone with him, he was like, man, if you ever have trouble, you know, just let me know. We could get on a Zoom and then I can help you out. And I felt that sincerity. So anytime I had trouble, he helped me out. So I was going through some trouble finding a client for one of my lead gens. And he was like, man, let's do some cold calls. First fucking cold call this man did. First fucking cold call. We found someone that was, you know, ideal prospect when we think of who we want to sell the lead gens to. It was the downhill prospecting method, what you find in the BAM course. So my client was taking Google ads for the same keywords that I was ranking number one for. And he was with a marketing company that was not doing shit. And funny, I'll transition into that as soon. So he turns out, send him some free leads, turn into a monthly deal. Then I turned back a few months later. Hey, I want to sell this site to you. I want to transfer the ownership to you. Sold it for a very big amount. 17,000. I sold my Legion for 17,000.
So you rented it for a while. You rented it for 9 months. How much did you rent it for? How much were you making? Let's say that 9 months. How much did you make in that 9 months that you were renting it before you sold it?
So it was for a couple of months. That Legion was doing commission for a lot of my commission guys who I ended up cutting because.
For how many months was it with them? Like 4 months?
So for the guy I ended up selling it to, we did two months of
I want to know like the lifetime of that lead gen. So you put it up and I don't care if you were renting it to some other guy or whatever. How much money do you think rent wise did you rent it for before you sold it? How much was that?
The commission, I can't give you an exact number because it was a little bit skewed off.
I remember it being like one time you were getting paid good and then the next month the guy was trying to fuck you. And so I remember it jumping, but there was still some money there. So what was it? Like 3-4 grand?
Still, yeah, something in that range. There was still money there. Yep. And then once Josh made that cold call for me, turned into a monthly deal for 2 months. And then I turned back around and I ended up flipping it because.
How much was the monthly deal with the guy you sold it to for the 2 months prior?
$850 and then ended up selling it.
So $1,700 there, and then you probably got a couple grand. So you're like 4 grand plus seven. How much did you sell it for?
$17,000.
$17,000? So you made like $21,000 on this lead gen. On that deal, plus you had that other lead gen that you made about 9,000. So you made 29,000 there just in selling a couple of your lead gens. And that's not all your lead gens, right? That's just a couple, just two of them.
Right. And I still have lead gens that are still bringing me in monthly income. And yeah. I mean, it's beautiful. I'm really looking back. And it's crazy because, you know, the leads are actually picking up now because most people are home. They're thinking of it's construction niches. So the leads are picking up. And, you know, the monthly is still coming in. All the leads are coming in. And it's all profit. When you rank organically SEO-wise, it's all fucking profit.
Yeah.
So think about that. You know, what business allows you to get even over 75 and it's 75% margin? And it's more. This is close. This is 95 and up if you think about it.
Bro, Calvin can tell you, we actually own about 15 businesses. So me and my wife own a lot of businesses. And most profit margins range between 10 to 20% on most of our businesses. So when I got into this marketing game, guys, my eyes went like this. I was like, holy shit, are you kidding me right now? I worked my ass off in a moving company for years. And I was happy as shit to pull an 18% profit margin. Right. Of course, I was doing millions of dollars in it. Right. But still 18%, I was elated. Right. And so like when you jump into a company like this and you're making 50, 70, like when you get good at this shit, you'll make 75% profit margin, 100% sometimes. We have customers right now pay us $3,500 a month. We haven't touched their shit in like 6-8 months. You know what I mean? So it's like that money just keeps rolling in and you're working on other shit. So it's just amazing. But on that one lead gen, it just amazes me that, you know what I mean? You were able to put up a lead gen that we can do this over and over. You put up a lead gen, you probably put maybe $1,000 into it, and you turn around and you sell it for over 20 grand, right? So who wouldn't want to be able to invest $1,000, use the tools on your tool belt, and go and make $20,000 real quick, right? How many people would love to do that? And so I think you're just inspiring a lot of students here to really see the potential in these lead gens. I feel like, yes, guys, I push SEO. Yes, I make a ton of money with SEO. But guys, remember my foundation right now. Like if I wanted to shut down everything I did in life and just go freaking live on the Bahamas for the rest of my life, I could, just with lead gen money, just with these foundations that are laid with lead gens. And we're putting up actively, I think the guys build 15 new lead gens every single month. And so that money just keeps climbing. It just keeps climbing. So you can do the same exact thing. You just gotta, let's take massive action and start setting these up like Ben did, like I did, like all these students you see in here are really killing it. They have tons of lead gens, and they're on top of that, they're selling SEO as well. And they're taking that SEO money and putting it back. Just like Ben's doing now. He's taking some of his SEO money and he's sinking it back into his lead gens. So we can't forget that aspect, but keep going. So you sold two of your lead gens. You still got more lead gens. You're probably making a couple grand a month on lead gens. You got SEO client. I know you got another SEO client getting ready to turn on here next month, right? And I think that's, yeah, you're getting ready to turn on another SEO client next month. So it's like everything's starting to roll for you, huh?
Yeah, and another thing you guys will learn as you go on, a lot of these businesses will pay marketing companies that aren't doing a fucking thing for them. And when you really do the due diligence, you'll see, guys, like we seriously, Josh and all the people in the group that have countless years of experience in this, they're sharing top knowledge that a lot of these big companies, they're not doing anything for these companies that they're, you know, collecting retainers from. It's just the truth. You'll see it as you go on. And we really, once you're really sold on what you do, it'll really take you to the next level. Like we seriously, so many different ways. Just think about just what GMB can do, what organic can do. And don't even like Facebook and social media, that's a whole nother ball game. And we're just doing this on Google. Like just imagine, you know, none of these so-called SEO companies are doing a freaking thing for them. So you come in, you offer value. Biggest thing, what I learned, just offer value. Don't really give them a vibe like you want anything in return. Just offer value, and over time, the good will start coming back to you. And then over time, with each client, with each week progressing, you know, as much as you guys, like I know when I first started, I was like, 10 fucking K now, 10 K now. And I was like, you know, and you can kind of get a bit impatient. But as much as of a impatient person I am, if you really just pursue it day in, day out, just keep going, have a plan and pick the right people to do business with. Have some standards. Don't just send leads to everyone. That was a big thing that I learned. I was being so needy, and I was like, oh my God, they want a lead. Let me send a lead to them. And then, you know, there's certain people you don't do business with, and you learn that over time. And I'm still learning. I'm nowhere near where I want to be. I have super high goals that I set for myself, and you know, it's never going to stop. And that's how I really believe everyone in here should be. But man, there's so much to learn in this business. Like I had no clue what business really was. I never did a cold call. I didn't know a freaking thing. And just through the fire, you learn so many valuable life skills that are just translatable in everything. And it's an amazing thing. I'm grateful to have Josh as my mentor. Josh has taught me so much. He's always been there for me. And that was something that I needed. a perfectionist myself. I needed someone to kind of take me under his wing. And Josh, I literally cannot thank Josh enough, seriously. So to all the new people in here, just be grateful that you're in the presence of this group, because there's not that many genuine, sincere people out here that really want to help you. Josh seriously wants to help you. I know I went through so many bumps along the road, and Josh helped me. You know, he's still helping me. He's still helping me with my SEO client, you know, and still, and it's not going to stop. And just be grateful, seriously, guys. And just keep going. Just keep going. It's not going to be perfect, and it's not going to be easy. It's not. But just fucking do it, and you're going to learn. Not every lead gen is going to hit. Not every client is going to work out. You're going to learn. And like Calvin just wrote in the comments,
trust the process. But right now, guys, it's time to take risk, right? Right now is your time to take risk. It's time to take chances for your life. Like if you're not taking chances, if you're not doing any of that shit, you don't have progress, right? So if you're not out there building a lead gen and failing at it to build another one to succeed, then you're not going to have progress in your life. You're not going to have happiness. You're going to continue to be in the same fucking cycle you're in. If Ben didn't continue to take chances, to take risk, continue to push forward, to put it all on the line, to close all other doors, he'd still be living at his parents' house, right? He would still be there. And look where he's at now. You got to take risks. You got to be ready. You got to take chances. You got to put yourself out there. And I promise you, I'm there every step of the way. Our coaches are there every step of the way. You just got to go. And you got to go right now. Okay? Yeah, Ben, it's been great talking to you on here. And I kind of want to lead you on. I want to ask you a few more questions. Tell me like some of... Like, I know you told us your background now, but tell me what the future looks like for you, like compared to what it was. Like, what does the future hold for you? Where are you going? You just said one important thing I want to touch base on before we move forward. You just said something that's really important, and I still do this. Me and Calvin do this every 6 months. So we all just had a company meeting, and what we do, guys, because time is super important, and who you spend your time with is going to determine where you end up. And so every 6 months, Mr. and Mrs. Lead sits down and we cut customers. I swear to God, even if they're paying us, we just cut a customer just recently, paid $1,500 a month. $1,500 a month, but they're a pain in the ass. So we cut them because they take up too much time. We can go get four other clients that pay $1,500 and spend just as much time with. So you got to start weighing out, is this person making me better? Is this person a person I want to grow with, right? And you'll start to think of that. Some of you aren't thinking that right now, and that's fine. It's a process. Go and get that money. Don't get mad at your money. Go and make it. But at some point, you have to start weighing out, is this client eating up too much of my time to where I could take that same time and make double that by bringing on two clients? You got to really think that through. And Ben's at that point right now in his career. And I promise you, it's not going to stop. Every 6 months, like Ben said, if you start bringing value to business owners, that karma just starts coming back. Things just start loading on you. You start having boards like this of waiting lines that can work with you, right? And when you start getting that, you got to start weighing time and money. You got to start weighing, is this going to bring me up or is this bringing me down? Are these people cool to work with or are they bad? So that's kind of what you have to look like. It looks like Ben cut out. I think Ben cut out here. Oh, there he's back. Ben, did you cut out?
Yep, I just cut out.
Yeah, you cut out for a minute there. But yeah, you got to weigh that shit. And you're going to hit that with your thing too. And Ben, moving forward, it's not going to stop. It's going to continue. You're going to hit a point to where either you're going to start building a team underneath you, or you're just going to say, you know what? I just want to work with these types of clients. I'm going to get myself to 20K, 30K, whatever it is. And that I'm happy. Right. So whatever that looks like to you in your goals and whether those have changed or not, that's totally up to you. But understand, it's not over when you get there, guys. You then have to reset your goals. And I talk about goals a lot inside this course. You want to continue to reset those goals. When you reach a new goal, set a new goal, right? Progress is happiness. Without progress, we start to get depressed. We start to go over here. We start pissing on other grass. And we think the grass is greener on the other side. And we go spin our wheels over there and waste time. So continue to set goals. Continue to strive for goals. Continue to reach for goals, right? So that was really important to me. But let's keep going. So what does the future look like for you now?
Man, I set lofty goals. I set really lofty goals. You know what I found? It's very interesting. There are three things that motivate people in this world. All right. So there is number one, they want to avoid pain. Okay. Then they want to stay the same, or they're more motivated by gaining pleasure. So I feel like once you know what really truly motivates you, then you can kind of get a feel and really take over the world. Like, I mean, me, I'm more motivated by avoiding pain for some reason. That's just me.
Yep.
Right. I just felt like I had to bring that up. But to segue into my goals, man, I want a home in another country. I want a house by the water. You know, these are some of the personal goals I set for myself. Obviously, financially, super, super lofty goals in order to get that done. And the biggest thing, biggest thing, and what Josh just alluded to, was who is on your team? Who are the clients that you have? So I made the hard decisions. And as you progress in business, you will have to make hard fucking decisions. And that's part of being in business. And that's what I'm learning. So personally, my personal associates, my personal friends, I cut out. I literally evaluated everyone that was in my contact list, and I fucking got rid of a lot of people, because it may sound fucked up, but you know, you are who you hang around. And if you really decide, like, okay, this is where I'm going, this is my mission, this is where I want to be, are these people contributing? Not really. Time to get rid of them. Same thing with clients. You know, I decided I didn't want to deal with a certain type of client. So I was like, hey, you know, I had some lead gems, you know, you could take it, you could sell it. I'll flip the lead gen to you. Or if not, I'm moving on, because I'm not dealing with this. So your progress can be, you know, severely limited if you're surrounded by the wrong people. And that's the hard fucking decisions that you need to make, you know, as it being in business. And I'm very glad Josh brought that up. And that's something that you got to do. And then you are who you fucking hang around. As harsh as that may sound, it's the truth. So where I'm going, man, I'm surrounding myself with people on the same mission, you know,
the journey,
you know, and
you never know where it's going to lead you, man. You never know. Like, you wake up tomorrow morning, all of a sudden you got 10 more customers knocking at your door, and it's the truth. I love the journey, right? Like, I can be out in fucking Phoenix because I'm running from COVID-19 and I want a house with a pool, right? And I'm just sitting out there, and all of a sudden I got three clients, right? Like, seriously, three clients while you're sitting next to a pool, and then you don't know where your life takes you after that, right? So you come home and you're like, oh shit, I want to go to TJ. And so that's where you're heading. That's exactly where you're heading. When you can align yourself with the right people, when you do exactly what you've just talked about, like, the last year went like this for you, right? It's kind of a slow climb. This next year is going to be a straight up cliff, bro. You're climbing the side of the mountain right now. And you got to keep that focus. You got to keep that vision, and you got to keep that grind day in and day out. And I'm telling you right now, when we have this conversation again next year, you might be making more money than me. You just might. You know what I mean? Like, you got the focus. That's all it takes, man. You got the focus, you trust the process, and you get in there and pound it out.
Let's keep going, man. It's never enough.
So if you had one piece of advice to give these any newbies or dudes that maybe been in for a minute, because Ben, there's some people in here that I've talked to, they've been in for 3 months, they haven't built out a lead gen, they built out their agency site, but they haven't done anything with it. So give some advice to some different levels, right? Maybe a guy that's brand new, just stepped in the door, or a guy that's been in 3-6 months or whatever.
Okay. First things first, pull the fucking trigger.
Pull the trigger.
Okay. Whatever it is, pull the trigger. You have an idea, pull the trigger. Okay. And then you'll learn from it. Another thing, really understand the material, understand how it works, how the process works, And then over time, you'll really start to know it. Like I said before, I could talk about this stuff in my sleep now. I can literally look at over time, you'll start to develop certain, ways of looking at things, and it just becomes, second nature. So really understand the material. Don't become too much of a perfectionist though. So understand pull the trigger, know the material, pull the trigger, and you got to sacrifice something. Whatever it is, sacrifice something. If you really want to be successful at it, it's very simple. You just got to put in the work. A lot of people don't want to hear that. They want to hear the easy way out. There's no real easy way out. I hate to break it to you. Pull the trigger.
So I hear two pieces of advice. One, pull the trigger. Two, put in the work, right?
Put in the work, pull the trigger, and you'll learn as you go. You really learn as you go. And you'll start to understand what it is that you want and what's important to you on your next path. And then through that, you'll learn. You'll start to see.
That's awesome. Thank you for jumping up here with me. Hey, listen, guys, stay on here real quick. I'm going to get Ben off of here, and then I'm going to pick somebody from the group to jump in. If you guys have questions, ask away. I might bring you in, and I can question you on here, and we can just talk to each other. If you're having a hard time getting over something, if you're having a hard time pulling the fucking trigger or putting in the work, I want to talk to you. Let's go. Ben, thank you. Love hearing your story, man. I can't wait to see the next fucking year with you. I can't wait to see the next 2 years. Imagine where you're going to be when you're 6+ years like I am sitting right now. Imagine where you're going to be, right? Imagine it. All right. Peace.
Thank you, Josh.
Yep. We move. There we go. All right. Let me jump in here. All right, so hold on 1 second, guys. Hey, listen, if you got a question, post it in the group real quick for me. I want to bring one or two of you guys on here to kind of talk to you. Bop, bop, bop. Corey, what's up? Let me get Ben at Take Over the World. Great stuff. I'm going to see what I can see and what I can't see. It's not letting me see all your comments here. Bam, bam, bam. All right, so let me get Zach, are you still watching in here? Let me bring Zach on real quick and answer some of his questions. I know he's just getting going. Hey, Zach, you know what? I got to get somebody that knows how to use a Zoom. Let me see. All right, Nick McCallan. I'm shooting you a Zoom link right now. Jump in. Bop, bop, bop. Oh, hey, what's up, Jose? I seen your, cancel. Let me see that real quick. Hey, I see your post right here. You're asking, hey, is SEO access tools safe to use? All right, listen. I've never used SEO access tools. A lot of members in this group do, okay? A lot of members use that, but I'm a full-blown agency. I have to pay for these tools outright. Me and Calvin, Danelle, we all spend, tools probably cost me 10 grand a month, 15 grand a month with all the tools we have. So, I don't use SEO access tools. I can tell you, Ben, who just got off of here with me, he uses that because we were just looking over his SEO deal for $4,100 a month that he's landed 6 months ago and he's been working on, but he needed help and he was in SEO access tools. So I'm guessing it's safe. But I'll let some of the members answer that for you. Okay. Where is it? Hey, Nick, it's in your Facebook message. I just sent it to you on Messenger. So jump on that link. Okay. Joyce says she hated SEO access tools. She uses One Click Group. She posted that link in here for you. So you can check that out as well. But members will tell you what they use, what they don't. But what these tools are, if you're new guys, what these tools are is like, all the tools we use, ARS, Majestic, all that shit. Well, there's group access tools. And instead of you paying $100 for this one, $15 for this one or that, there's group access tools. And there's a bunch of different groups that people use in the group. Joyce is saying One Click Group is the best. I haven't used any of them. but I know they give you access to these tools for like $30 a month or $15 or $50 a month. There's different packages you can choose and you just share the tools. It's like group share things, but you're not spending the type of money that I have to spend to use these tools. It gives them to you really cheap so you can get started, get the same tools, get the same training as everybody else for one steady cost, okay? And that's what they're talking about right now. Let me see if he jumped on here. Looks like not yet. Nick, see if that's in your, go ahead and check your messenger. Let me see. Yeah, it says you've seen it. So jump on that link here in a second when you get a chance and I will let you in. But in the meantime, guys, I really love talking to Ben, right? Like Ben came in fresh, college student, 5 years, fucking paying student debt, bunch of bullshit, right? Didn't learn really anything about business in there whatsoever, but comes out, takes a chance on a course, puts it all on the line, right? Puts it all on the line. Sure, he's going to stumble. Everybody stumbles, guys. We have those times that ups and downs and times that are doing really good where we hit that double, right? There's even times where we hit the home run and we feel great. And there's times where you're going to have downs, right? But at the end of the day, we got to train our mind to never quit. We got to be hungry. We got to go after it. Like we got to go after it. Like our life depends on it. Okay. And hold on real quick, guys. Nick just jumped in. Promote. Cool. We'll jump in. And if you got questions, ask away. If enough of you have questions and you want to jump on this Zoom with me, I will bring you in. Give me 1 second here. Nick, you're going to have to start your video if you want to. Let's see. You don't have to. I'm going to ask, but whatever. Nick, can you hear me?
Yep.
Cool. What's up, dude?
Hey.
I know, like, you've been hitting me with questions. You're like, you got a lot going on, right?
Yeah, earlier, sorry about the robe. I was running in the rain. It started running. I got soaked. I come in and take a shower, but you're on. So I'm like, fuck the shower. I'll just get a robe and listen to you.
It's cool, man. It's cool. Like, what other business do you know where you can show up in a robe, right? Like,
as long as it's sealed, we're good here.
Yeah, I'm down with it. I love it.
Yeah.
So you've only been in a short amount of time, right? What do you think so far? Like, I know you came from another group. You've actually been in a few other groups, right?
One other group.
Okay. So you've been in one other group. How long were you in that group for?
Since November. So what's that? 6 months?
6 months. So you're 6 months in there. And then how long you been in this one?
Maybe 2 weeks.
Cool. So what do you think so far of this group so far?
This answered a lot of the questions that I had from the other group.
This is the kind of,
once you learn it, what can I do with it? So this answers the question, what can I do with it?
So you get, so like, explain that a little bit more. So you sure. Came in, you probably learned some of the tools, right? From the other group, all that kind of stuff.
Right.
And then you jumped in here, but you didn't really know. You're like, okay, I got all these tools. You didn't really know how to imply them or make money with them really. And so you came in here and that kind of answers your questions or even more deep dive stuff. Maybe you knew about citations, but you didn't really know how to go get them, or you knew about links, but you didn't really know how to go get them. Or just tell me a little bit about your background. Like, do you have lead gens right now? What do you have going on? And do you have any
questions? I've got about 21 lead gens if you include the agency.
Good job. Six months, 21 lead gens.
I bought them all, you know, because I figure if I know how to do it, then I could outsource it and focus on the smarter stuff. That's just Perfect. The best way for me. What I'm learning here, and I haven't gone through all the training yet, there's something like 220 videos. It's crazy the amount of videos that there are.
Right.
And I hear that beep in my sleep, that beep, beep, you know, when it first comes on.
Yeah.
It's cool. So what I'm learning though is, how can I get these lead gens to either make money faster, or I've got this tool, but I didn't know there were advanced settings on this tool that could help me out. Does that make sense?
Yep.
And there's been a lot of good people that have friended me, that I've talked to, that I've asked questions of. And right now I'm starting to have questions that I wouldn't have had, you know, 2 weeks ago, because I'm thinking in a different track.
So it's opening your mind to new things.
Yeah, definitely.
And then what about level of like one-on-one and stuff? How is that like compared to the other groups you're in? Compared, like, tell me the difference of what.
I'm not getting anyone in trouble, okay?
No, you're not.
The video or some shit.
No trouble.
The funny thing is, whenever you and I have been on the phone, it's probably been like three times and we've chatted. So Josh, y'all know Josh is busy all the fucking time. I talk to him when he's in Arizona. He's always got shit going. But when he's on the phone with you, it's like, it's just you. And you're like, shit, an hour went by. I appreciate that. So that's been good.
Okay, perfect. So you're getting what you need. You're moving forward. Do you have any questions? Like, what do you think might help some of these new students question-wise that would open them up a little bit?
Well, one of the things I learned from someone today, I don't know what group they were in, but she builds her own sites and she has the content written. And as soon as the content's written without pictures or anything, she throws it up as soon as possible, right? Yeah. To start get indexed and content get read and things like that.
Yep.
I think in this group, what everyone's got to figure out, I'm still figuring it out. You have purchased the tools, you've purchased the education. It's going to fucking work. It's a formula. You could break everything down into numbers. But if you don't have the discipline to say, okay, today, this is what I'm doing. Boom, 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 boom. You lose days and weeks and months. And I've talked to people in other groups. It's like, when did you get in? Oh, I got in 6 months ago, but I started, you know, a month ago. You can't lose that, because my biggest regret right now is I wish I had more sites. I wish I did more earlier.
Yeah. Yeah. And then the current sites that you have right now, you know, obviously we need to get in there. We need to get some more of them sold. We need to get that moving. You know what I mean? And then, like, I'm sure I know there's a few different things like keyword research, keyword difficulty, that kind of stuff.
There was a lot more. I didn't understand difficulty from the first course. So I was ranking for keywords that weren't that important and there weren't a lot of searches. Now that I understand difficulty and volume and what I could expect to have searched, I'd rather spend time going for one keyword than nailing three.
Yeah, absolutely. Cool. So do you have any questions for me at all?
Yeah. I got
you. Go. And I were, that's what I'm here for. Let's make it happen. Okay.
There's one from our chat today that I didn't fully understand. I ain't going to say you didn't fully answer. I didn't fully understand it. Okay.
All right.
So I'd have to open up the chat, but it was something. It was for my, I got this concrete lead gen. It's getting $35 a lead, but I think I'm going to switch guys. I think I'm going to go to someone else. He just fucks it up too much.
Okay.
One of the questions was something about, as you're setting up My Business for Google,
mm-hmm.
and you want to look up your business under Google My Business, and it gives you a link.
Yeah.
That link you then use for something else. Well, I must have messed up because I shot you a copy of that link and it was literally like the whole Facebook page.
Yeah. I didn't answer back because I was getting ready for this.
You were scared of the link. The link was giant.
I clicked on your link and it just took me to a blank page. I was like, no, this isn't right.
So yeah, I don't know what I was doing.
I'm originally going to go in there, find your business for you, and shoot you the right link.
Yeah, the link was like this. Where's the camera? The link is like this thick. It took the whole text field.
Hey, Well, check this out. Let's see if we can do this. I don't know if this is even possible.
Hey, and earlier, I gotta make a disclaimer. Yeah. About a week ago, I broke my tooth. It's a veneer. I broke it on fucking Laffy Taffy. My wife starts laughing at me about it. I got to get it fixed. But
no, that brings up something real quick that I want to bring up. So guys, like, listen, like, you guys see this teeth? This is like $30,000 in teeth. Okay.
They're expensive.
I didn't pay a fucking penny for it. This is all traded work.
Wait, was that Tijuana?
No. This shit was right here. It's Dr. Hill. Nice. All traded work for a website build. Okay. And then he still paid us for SEO. And then out here, my deck's getting done right now. A $32,000 to $35,000 bid is what we got. Straight trade. Upstairs, granite's coming in next week. Straight trade. Like, I have traded so much on top of all the money we make. I probably trade anywhere from $100,000 to $150,000 a year in traded work. So if you own your house and you want something done, go build a fucking lead gen. Go give it to a guy and trade him out work. That's how you can get started. Say, hey, listen, I'll give you leads for 6 months. Come do my granite. Hey, I'll give you freaking website build. Come do this. Hey, I'll do this. Come do this, right? And it's just one thing after another. There's so many ways to utilize what you guys have learned. But hold on a second, Nick. I think I found something pretty cool in here. Let me know, guys, if you can see my actual screen.
Yeah, we see it.
You can see it. I wonder if they can see it.
That's all right, right.
So I'm waiting to see. Let me see real quick. Bop, bop, bop. Let's see. Yep, they got it. Perfect. All right, Nick. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up a screen here and give me your business name.
Concrete Services. You know what? Just type in Concrete Services Bend, Oregon, and it'll pull up. I don't remember the name.
Okay. And I'm looking for the GMB.
I'm the first one on the GMB.
This is you.
And you can see I'm the first one organically. Yeah.
So this is you and this is you.
I should have a third one. Yeah.
Okay. So the process works.
Yeah, fuck it. What? And by the way, for the people who are new, when you're building this shit, when you see this come up and then you go to someone else's computer and you go incognito and you grab your wife's phone or shit like that and stuff, it works.
Sick. So this is what you needed, Nick. All you do is you touch this business. See how it pops up right here? Yeah. You're just going to grab this up here.
There's a ton of that. All right.
All right.
Hey, send it to me.
That's what they were looking for when they were asking you for that. So let me stop share. Let me see if I can even do that. Oh shit. I might have messed this whole thing up. Boom, boom, boom. Nope. Ah. All right. You want me to send it to you?
Yeah. The link seems to be huge though when I sent it to you.
Yeah. Let me see. Well, because you're doing it on Facebook, I think it adds a bunch of stuff on Facebook.
All right.
So give me your email real quick and I'll send it to you on Gmail.
Yeah. It's Nick.
One second.
At.
It should pop up. Give me a second. There you go.
Yep. Nick, N-I-C-K, at G, the number 3.agency. Which is a cool agency name, by the way.
There you go.
That's simple. All right. Thanks for sending that.
Bam. Oh, no, it's long. It's super long.
All right,
we'll check it out. Here, let me go to sent real quick, though. At least this one should pull up. Let me make sure that.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
Yep, but they're just looking for that exact page right there is what they're looking for. So let me pull this back, see if I can get this blown up. Meeting controls. Stop share. Bam, we're back. All right, cool. So that's pretty cool that we can do that on this as well. I'm just learning this tool as well. This is a Zoom webinar. Actually allows you to go live and bring people into your chat at the same time. So pretty cool. And it looks like we get to share the screen as well.
And before, by the way, so that site's been sitting at that position for a while, but the GMB was only 60% complete until I finished the GMB training today. I was missing out a bit.
You're missing out a bit. Cool, man.
Yeah, I didn't have enough photos. I could take more advantage of the content. There were just a lot of things I ignored that now I know.
Awesome. Well, do you have anything else for me?
No, I love the one-on-ones. When you had Ben on, that was fabulous.
Cool. Well, I'll see you soon. I might bring in somebody else here. I think my wife was raising her hand. Let's see what Danelle Osborne's doing. All right, Nick, I'll talk to you tomorrow. Cool.
Later.
All right, let's get Miss Danelle in here. If she's watching, let's see, new message. Paste. Oh shit, wrong one. One second, I messed that up. Oof. Give me a second, guys. I posted that big link I copied. Bad news. Danelle, if you're on here, get ready. I'm going to send you a link to your messenger. You just jump on your phone or whatever. Oh, can't use this feature right now. Did that kill it? Slow down. Close. Post comments, close, confirm, close, cancel. Oh man, this is playing big games on me. I don't know if you guys can still see me or not. This whole thing is like shut down right now. Let me see. Can you guys still see me? All right, either way, I can't see you guys. I can't invite anybody anymore. I hope you guys had a good night. I hope you learned a lot from Ben. I hope you learned a lot from Nick. I hope you learned a lot from me. At the end of the day, what I want you guys to take from this night, what I want you guys to understand is that you got to train your mind, right? You cannot quit. You can never quit, okay? You might take a hiatus. You might slow down a little bit, but you can't quit. If you want to be Ben, if you want to be me, if you want to be Calvin, if you want to be any of these guys in here really killing it, even Ren Taylor. Ren just started selling 30 days ago, dude, and it's already like freaking killing it, right? So if you want that, right, you got to be hungry. You can't quit. You got to stay focused. Just like Ben said, you got to cut off the things that aren't bringing you value to your life, okay? And understand this, and I understand this very well because I've been at this game for a really long time, right? Having balance with family, fitness, finance, faith is great, but having progress and moving forward in all four of those areas creates happiness. So with that, guys, I'm going to go ahead and end this right here, right now. I'll talk to you guys later. Much love.